Right, very much on the way now to being set up, just cutting the glass. Now, there are a number of ways to fiberglass this. Single layer, straight down, two layers, straight down. But we've got a bit of a detail up at the top there that needs a lot of concentrating on. So, rather than kind of be working down here, I just want to concentrate right on that top bit. It's really, really important on this particular job above all others, right? Now, the way I've decided to do it is get up on my hoppy up, and I'm cutting that glass at 4 foot, which takes me down, you know, below that fitting and below the what's going to be an invisible joint line. What that means is I can stand up there and get that detail absolutely bang on. That is all. If I just tip up, like get on my tiptoes, I'm at eye level with it, perfect. And then put all four drops, it's 3.8 meters, four drops in two layers and a tissue, takes me right into that corner. Then, without letting this sort of go off, I can really leisurely do this lower section in another 4 foot drop. In fact, it's 1.1 to take me onto the foam on the floor. Now, one thing we have got going on in this pond is vapor. I could taste that G4 that is on the floor down there outside when I went for a walk last night. It's vile stuff, worse than fiberglass. Now, as we've spoken about many times before, we've got that fan there and that one there. As we've spoken about many times before, this stuff stinks. I'm not complaining about it. I know what it's like full well. And when I talk about not fighting opposing forces, such as coming all the way down on a big long drop, section it out, try and get there, try and control the environment to a certain point as well, as much as you can. So that fan up there is pointing outwards towards that open door in the hope that it takes some of the vapor out with it. Will it make that much of a difference? This little fan here, that's going to be switched off when I put the tissue on because it'll blow the tissue all over. That's just to literally tickle a bit of air about, you know, there's no styrene removal. Now, with styrene being heavier than air, it is going to kind of drop to the bottom of the pond, but it is still emanating off this resin on the wall right into my face. Nothing I can do about it. Tickle a bit of air through, maybe that'll help me out. Now, one thing that is often asked or suggested is, can I put a fan on a bit of flexible pipe outside the pond attached to the bottom drain? It's been mentioned many, many times. And in some circumstances, that would be feasible. The idea being, styrene's heavier than air, it all drops to the bottom, but really it doesn't. As I've just said, it comes off this way as well. But you could remove some of it by dragging it through the bottom drain and exhausting it outside. But where that wouldn't work sometimes is in a confined filter room where there's nowhere to put a fan. B, the filters might already be connected up to it, so that's not going to work. I'm not going to go disconnecting the customer's solvent wells just to put exhaust some vapor out of here. And C, in this case, it might be outside where I don't want to get a great big fan getting piss wet through outside. So all these things have been mentioned, discussed and talked about before. This is my preferred method of getting rid of it. And on this job, if the vapour buildup gets too much, which it absolutely would do on a red hot day, you would not catch me in this pond doing this on a red hot day, yeah? The vapour would literally beat you back. You wouldn't be able to tolerate it in here. I certainly wouldn't anyway. So if the vapour build up does get a bit much, then I know I can get this on, I know I can get this wall on. When it starts to really set and give, you know, start not cooking but going off, I just get out and take a break. It's quite simple. And then drop the fan in the opposite way around and blow the vapor up and out with the fan over there. It's all getting just complicated, but you know, as a GRP guy, you just tough these things out. It's always interesting how often the customer will say, that stuff stinks, how do you tolerate it? And it's just fiberglass, we do it. Right. So, 4 foot. You see my difficulty? Can you see the difficulty I would have without any elevation, either that hoppy up or my board? Trying to get, I can't see into it, so get up, tuck the glass right in, and because these coping stones, they're already covered in G4, so it doesn't matter if I get a little bit of resin. I'm not going to go chucking it all over. It's not going to matter if I get a little bit of resin on there. Where we join up onto yesterday's glass, just... give it a tickle, quick denib. And a wipe down in a minute when I come in with the sauce. Right, I'm gonna crack on. That fresh air is rather nice. Bit different in there. Now, I am not hamming this up. I've no reason to ham it up. It stinks. Yesterday, I got all of this section done. My head is well above the line of the fiberglass, and the open door's right there. Today, I've got that wall done. That wall done, and I'm about to finish that front wall down there to join this one up to the bigger one. But I ain't going in there yet. Wear a mask. Nah. Imagine what it's like to be pepper sprayed by the police. Is that what they use? Mace? Some incapacitant, whatever it is. That's what your eyes would feel like if you went down in there. That's why that big fan is running there. Oh, the smaller one, the battery's run out on the smaller one. I'll go and put a new battery in that. Yeah, that's not pleasant down there. And like I say, I am not hamming that up. Especially not to deter anybody having a go themselves. Far from it. I'm being completely truthful and completely realistic. I won't be going back down in there until that smell is dissipated. Now, we haven't got smell-o-vision on YouTube, so the best you've got is my description of what's going on as to what it smells like. Nice fresh air out there, not so bad at that end. Down there and in the pond, it's like... bleh. Nah, mate, you're all right. I ain't going back in there yet. Which is why I'll do sessions at a time before that vapour builds up. That's built up while I've been out making a cup of tea. So let that dissipate. It smells like... if you put nail varnish in an oven for 5 minutes and then put your head in it. Not that I would suggest you do that, of course, but that's about what I can imagine it smells like when it gets really going. I mean, I did all that in one session. The smell never bothered me at all. I've mentioned it in a longer video, but now I have said this in other videos, that women, customers' wives, tend to like the smell of this. Oh, Matt, that's nice. What is it? Yeah, you're here countless times on the videos. The customers leant on the wall watching me working, and they'll say to me, Matt, oh, how can you stand that smell? And they're knocked back by it like that. But, you know, I don't work to that point where it gets that offensive. And it is at that point of being very, very offensive right now, which is why I'm going to knock about at this end for a bit. So, when I've done finished moaning, I'm just going to, like I say, do this front wall. That will leave that wall for tomorrow and the floor, which also needs foam lining because it hasn't been fully foam lined because that platform is in there. That's a decent enough session tomorrow. There's some titivating all around the top with some bonding paste. And then that'll leave Friday for flow coat and wrap the job up. Yeah, give that. By the time I've done my tea, I can cut the glass on this top section, which is why I did this job like this, so I can use this as a working platform, rather than being down there in all that smell, see? Up here for thinking and all that, yeah? There is not enough man in me, in fact, it's not about having enough man in me to be able to be going down there. It's not having enough stupidity, knowing what it's like in deep ponds, in enclosed spaces like this. So, all told now, less than an hour at the job. I could, obviously that smell will dissipate, could put a beast session in and crack on with that long wall there, just leaving the floor for tomorrow, but slow and steady wins the race. And to as good a standard as I can get it, you know, within reason. Yeah. Ted, I've given you my updates, obviously, throughout the day with my bits and pieces, so you know where we're at. So, yeah, look at about Friday.